अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द लेक्चर ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 12th आईटी। द टॉपिक नेम इज एडवांस्ड जावास्क्रिप्ट, चैप्टर नेम इज एडवांस्ड जावास्क्रिप्ट एंड वी वर सॉल्विंग प्रैक्टिकल क्वेश्चंस, राइट। नाउ टुडेज क्वेश्चन इज राइट जावास्क्रिप्ट इवेंट ड्रिवन प्रोग्राम टू फाइंड आउट एरिया ऑफ अ सर्कल, accept the value of radius from user. This is the question, and hint given for this question is pi is equal to, that is phi is equal to 3.14. okay, this is the hint given in your question. Now what is the formula to calculate the area of a circle? To calculate the area of a circle, the formula is area is equal to phi into r, that is phi r square, right? Where in your question the hint is given that pi, the value of pi is 3.14, right? That means the value of pi is given as 3.14, and the formula to find out the area of a circle is pi r square, right? Now we will start with our program, with our first program, that is write JavaScript event driven program to find out area of a circle. Okay, now we will see the program to find out area of a circle. First we will see the output. What you are supposed to do, you are supposed to create a page, web page, and where you are supposed to call an event, right? You are supposed to activate an event. When you are supposed to activate an event, when you click on this button, right? So after clicking on this button, you are supposed to ask the user to enter the value of radius. You are supposed to ask the value of radius from user, right? So how do you ask the value of radius from user? How do you ask any value from user? By using prompt box, right? So this is the prompt box where you are asking the value of radius from the user. Okay, so if suppose user has entered the value of radius as 5, and when he press OK, then you're supposed to display the value of radius entered by the user and the area calculated by using this radius value. Okay, so here the value entered for radius is 5. What user has entered? The value of radius as 5, and radius area of a circle is 78.5. This is the area calculated by using the radius as 5. Okay, so here you have calculated the radius value. When it has been activated? When user clicks on this button. Right, so when user clicks on the button, you are supposed to ask the value from user. User will enter any value, whatever value user is going to write. You are supposed to calculate the area of a circle on the basis of that radius entered by the user. Got it? Now see students, we are going to see the program for this. As it is an event driven program, so you are supposed to create a button first. So doc type HTML, HTML body H1, the highest level of heading. We are going to display program to display the area, program to display the area of a circle, right? This is the program, this is the heading, highest level of heading, that you are supposed to write down the program to display the area of a circle, right? This is the highest level of heading which is going to be displayed here as an output. See, when you write here, it will display program to display area of a circle, right? Okay, and there is a button. So to create this button, we use button tag. Button on click is equal to fun1. What is this? On click is equal to fun1. This is an event, okay, where on click is an event handler. That means when to activate this function on clicking on a button. So on clicking is an event handler, and function one is the action. Okay, this fun one is the action taken on clicking on the button. Now display area of a circle, this is the label on the button. This display area of a circle, this is the label on the button, and then close the button tag. It is compulsory to close the button tag. So whatever you write between this opening and closing of the button, it will display that value as the label on the button. Okay, now we will start with script tag function fun1. This is the function declaration. When this function is going to be called? When it exists, right? So before calling a function, you are supposed to create a function also, right? So we are going to create a function first, then it has been called here after clicking. Okay, so function is a keyword which is used to create a function. Function fun1. Fun1 is my function name. Okay, r is equal to pass in. What is the value of r? R is a variable which is used to store the radius of a circle. We are going to ask the radius of a circle from user, right? So how to ask the value from user? By using prompt box. Correct. So whatever value we are accepting from the prompt box, whatever value you are asking from the prompt box, that value is in type of string. First we need to convert that string value into integer value, okay, and then we can use that value in our calculations. So to convert the accepted value into integer, we use parseInt method. ParseInt is a method which is used to convert the accepted value, or which is used to convert the string value or any value into integer value. So whatever value we are getting from prompt, we are going to convert that value into integer by using ParseInt. Okay, after ParseInt, we are asking the user to enter the value of radius by using prompt box. See, here we are asking the value to enter the value of radius by using prompt box. This is the prompt area. Prompt enter the value of radius. Correct? User, whatever user is going to enter, we are going to convert this value into integer value first. And then we are going to store that integer value in variable r. Got it? So whatever value user is going to enter, it is stored in r value variable. Okay, then document.write value entered for radius is, we are going to display the value entered by the user for radius. Value entered for radius is r. This is the value entered by the user in r. Okay, see, when by using prompt box, we are asking the user to enter the value, whatever value user is going to enter. Then after clicking on OK, that value is passed in a variable, and then we have displayed that value. Value entered for radius is 2. This is what value entered by entered for radius is 2. So we have displayed that by using document.write method. Document.write value entered for radius is and plus r. Plus r, by we use plus sign to join the value of r and to join this constant value. Okay, so we have displayed this statement. After that, what is the formula? The formula to find out the area of a circle is pi r square, right? Where the value of pi is given, that is 3.14. It is given in your question as a hint. So where pi is equal to, the value of pi is given as 3.14. Okay, so that value of pi, we are going to keep this value in our formula. So the formula is variable area is equal to, this is the formula, area is equal to pi r square, where the value of pi is given as 3.14 and the value of r is the value which is entered by the user. So we will multiply that value twice with pi value. Okay, so the formula is area is equal to pi r square. So we will keep this formula and we will calculate that our area, and then we will store that area in area variable, where area is equal to pi r into r. Okay, this is the formula to calculate the area of a circle. Then we will write document.write. We will give a line break. See, we will give a line break to display the next statement in new line. Okay, after giving a line break, we are going to display area of a circle is. What we are going to display? We are going to display area of a circle is, and then we will display the value calculated by using formula. Okay, so 12.56, this is the area calculated by using this radius. Okay, So we will display area of a circle is, this is the constant statement which will display in new line by using this br tag, and then plus to join the value with the area calculated above. Okay, we have calculated the area here, so it is a variable. Okay, where this value is going to save? In this variable. So we are going to display this variable value. Okay, got it? I hope you have understood this. See the program once again. What we are supposed to do? We are supposed to display this statement, and then we are supposed to create a button. On clicking on this button, we are supposed to ask the user to enter the radius. Whatever radius user is going to enter, we need to calculate that area of a circle by using the radius entered by the user. Got it? See the program once again. This is the program where we have displayed the statement, highest level of heading by using h1 tag. Then we have created one button by using button tag. Then on clicking on this button, we have called an event, we have activated an event, and we have taken the action as fun1, where fun1 is a function which is going to call after clicking on a button. Okay, and display area of a circle. Display area of a circle is what? This display area of a circle is a label on the button. Okay, and then we have started the script tag to create the function which has been called after clicking on a button. So to create a function, we use function keyword. This is the keyword which is used to declare that we are creating a user defined function. Okay, so fun1 is a user defined function which is declared by function keyword. Function is a keyword which is used to declare or to create a user defined function. This is the name of the function. Then where r is equal to, what we are going to do, we are going to ask the user to enter the value of radius, right? So to ask the a value from user, whatever value you are asking from user, we are supposed to ask that value by using prompt box. Prompt is a box which is going to be pop up on the screen to ask the value. Okay, to ask the user to enter something in the text box by pressing OK, that value is going to store in a variable. Okay, so it is asking user to enter the value of radius, right? We are asking the user to enter the value of radius. Whatever value user is going to enter in this prompt box, that is going to be converted into integer value by using this parseInt method. ParseInt method is used to convert the accepted value from the user into integer value. Okay, and then that integer value is going to store in this r, as we are going to use this value in our calculation. Okay, further we are going to use it in our calculations. So you are supposed to convert that integer, that value, accepted value, into integer. Okay, it is compulsory to convert that value into integer. Then that value is going to store in variable r. Now after that, we are going to display what value we have accepted from the user. What we are accepted from the user, the value of r. So we are going to display value entered for radius is. This is the statement. Then along with this statement, we are going to display the value entered by the user. Where is that value stored? Entered by the user, the value is stored in r variable. So we will display r variable. It is not in double quotes. It is out of that double quote, right? Because the value is stored in this. If you write it in double quote, it will display only r. Okay, so what we need to display, we need to display the value is stored in this r variable. So to display the value stored in a variable, we require that variable name without double quote. Okay, so value entered for radius is, the value entered for radius is plus r, the value of r. Got it? And then where pi is equal to 3.14, this is what, the value of pi which is given in your question. The value of pi is given in your question as a hint that pi is equal to 3.14. So we will use the same value in our program. And the formula to display or to calculate the area of a circle is, area is equal to 5r squared. where the value of 5 is given as 3.14, the value of r is accepted from the user. So we will multiply the value of r twice with the 5 value. Okay, so here if suppose user has entered the value of r as 2, so the formula will be 5r square 3.14 into 2 into 2. This is the calculation part, right? And it will be calculated and the output will display as, see, the output will display as 12.56. Got it? Understood this? So I hope you have understood this. Then after calculating, after calculation, after we calculate the area by using the formula, we are going to display that output as on the screen, right? So area of a circle is, this is on the next line, correct? To display the output in next line, we require a break tag. So BR tag is required to display the statement in next line. Then area of a circle is, this is the statement which is going to display here, area of a circle is, okay, and then 12.56 is what? This is the value calculated from the formula, okay, area, where that value is stored after calculation in area variable. So we will display plus area. Got it? I hope you have understood this program very well. This is very important question which may come in your online exam for 5 marks. So students, if you have any doubt, please note it down. This is very simple program, okay, and as it is an event driven program, it is compulsory to create the button first and then it is compulsory to call an event. So to call an event, we require a button, right, or any element where you are going to call an event. So we will create a button first to call an event. Then after creating a button, we are going to call a function. Got it? So students, we are going to stop here. In next lecture, we will calculate the area of a triangle and area of a square. Got it? We'll stop here. Thank you so much. Thank you.